Welcome back, friends. Today we're going to be talking about why self-disclosure is good for relationships. Let's talk about it. What is self-disclosure and what are the benefits of doing it? Self-disclosure is an aspect of communication that involves intentionally sharing personal information about ourselves with another person. Or it may be thought of as the process that grants other people access to our secrets or our real self. Technically, any form of communication reveals something about ourselves. The topics we choose to discuss, the self-assuredness in our voice, and the levity of our storytelling all communicate things about us. In psychology, though, none of these are examples of self-disclosure, as they do not intentionally reveal something, like a belief, a thought, a feeling, an experience, hope, or dreams that others would not know if not for sharing it, for us sharing it. There are several features of self-disclosure that scientists have explored. These are accessibility. This is how easy or difficult it is for the discloser to share the information. Reward value. How positive or negative is the experience of self-disclosing for the discloser or the listener? Informativeness. How much breadth is there? Variety of topics disclosed or depth and level of intimacy of the topics discussed. Truthfulness, how true is the disclosure and how much does it represent the discloser's true self? Social norms, how much does the disclosure adhere to or go against what's socially acceptable in a larger society? Effectiveness, how much does the disclosure help the discloser and listener achieve their goals, building intimacy, connection, or understanding? These factors, along with the intensity and frequency with which we disclose personal details, shape the types of relationships we have with people in our lives, our family, friends, co-workers, and other communities. For example, if we discuss virtually nothing at all, people often have a hard time to connect with us. They don't really know who we are. If we disclose too much too often, others might feel overwhelmed or burdened by the content of our self-disclosure. That's why when it comes to self-disclosure, just the right amount of sharing is what we're aiming for. The benefits of self-disclosure. Self-disclosure is thought of as beneficial for forming close, intimate social connections. Three things seem to explain why that is. People like someone more who discloses to them. People like someone more who they have disclosed to, and people disclose more to someone they like. This is how self-disclosure not only builds on itself, but generates upward cycles of the self-disclosure that helps build strong intimate relationships. In addition to the interpersonal benefits of self-disclosure, we often experience intrapersonal benefits or internal mental health benefits. For example, self-disclosure can help us achieve a sense of catharsis, clarification on the topic, and increase social support, which feels good. In contrast, research suggests that concealing personal thoughts and feelings or not self-disclosing them can be a stressor on the body, harm immunity, and even possibly lead to disease. Revealing this suppressed or silenced information can help alleviate the stress and improve health. Overall, self-disclosure is thought to be good for mental health. Of course, the benefits depend largely on the response of the person hearing the self-disclosure. If the response is negative, benefits might not be there. If self-disclosure is good, why don't we disclose everything? If self-disclosure is so good, why don't we do it more often? What keeps us from disclosing things? Some common reasons include the topic is taboo, such the topic feels too personal to share, such as abuse. The topic is undesirable, such as habits, bad habits that are very dirty. The topic is too difficult to divulge, such as having cheated on a romantic partner. The topic is too burdensome, such as debt or disease. The topic is private, such as information one desires to be kept to themselves. Sometimes self-disclosure of these difficult things doesn't feel right to us, and that's okay. For example, large self-disclosure at the beginning of a friendship or relationship are often thought to be inappropriate. Unplanned spontaneous self-disclosure in response to a question or another person's disclosure can also be tricky. We may end up sharing more than we intend or get an undesirable response that we were not prepared for. So before self-disclosing, it can be helpful to decide if you want to disclose information in person through a letter or in a phone call, through video or through another medium, or not at all. The medium you choose for self-disclosure can change how effective it is or help you to manage some of the more difficult parts of self-disclosure. In summary, self-disclosure or sharing intimate details about yourself isn't always easy. It's not always apparent why you should even do it. But when we look at the research, we can see that sharing our authentic selves with others may be the key to happiness and intimacy in relationships.